Yes, my name is Aine Christopher, the newly appointed deputy RCC Mbarara. I think my appointment by His Excellency is a great honor, and I think there is a way I'm feeling that I've been served a great honor to serve my nation as well. Yes. To have an opportunity to serve. Yes. It was by surprise. I did not expect that His Excellence may appoint me as the deputy RCC. But like I said, this is a very big honor to me, and I'm really very grateful to His Excellence for entrusting me with this opportunity to serve my nation. Yes, personally, I believe I have the capacity to do the job which is entrusted in me. And another thing, you know, leadership comes from God. So if His Excellence can really think giving me this opportunity is worth it, then why not? You know, there are some people who really made us believe that they have a monopoly of knowledge and the capacity of handling national issues. So I really think this is an opportunity for me to do my best and really serve Ugandans. Being back is different. You see, the reason why people are scattered out there in opposition or forming small groups, it's because maybe they don't have a voice. They don't have an opportunity to fix what they think is wrong. But really, if I'm given an opportunity, a platform to fix whatever I think is wrong at my level, then really, I'm just grateful for this. Once you feel that there is something wrong in the system, you really try all avenues to make sure that something is done and fixed. So really, if I've been unveiled an opportunity like this, I think the challenge should be back to me then to prove if I've been saying corruption is really restraining our people down, to see that I can put a stop on that. Yes. Not otherwise, then becoming a problem myself. I have not betrayed anyone. Betrayed who? Over what? Which struggle actually now? Changing government? I'm telling you, for me, I have not been following people sheepishly. I've had issues. We've been working together on principles, national principles. So that is exactly what I say, that if I think there's something wrong and they are saying, no, please, let's fix it together, what's wrong with that? Yes, my agenda, first of all, I think I'm a blessed person because the person I'm going to deputize is a very, very, very good and hard-working man. He's called Lieutenant Colonel Mwesigwa. Very experienced, very honest. Really, I'm blessed to be under that person because I know him. I know his background. I know his principles. Me serving under him, I think, first of all, that is an opportunity. That is a blessing by itself. Then again, first of all, we have to safeguard our people. They have to understand that whatever has been going on with the right now in this COVID period is to safeguard them. There is nothing else on that. Once we are all alive, I wanted to start with me personally, with the youth. We see how we can be creative. The creativity, we see how we can have programs and how those programs can be protected, because we have very many people who think otherwise. They look at everything as an opportunity. So my first agenda was that, since I have an old man I'm working with, I wanted mainly to focus on the youth, yes, to make sure that there are programs. Now we have this program which the president brought recently, Emioga. I think they are very beneficial. Once, if they are protected, really, for me, I will be very happy. We have been, whatever I've been doing, I have been doing it on principle. You cannot get me anywhere saying that I've been fighting a personal war, or a personal, something which is personal. No, these were national issues, which with my consent, I felt something needed to be done. And here comes an opportunity to be part of the people who can do something to make sure at least you contribute for the good of the nation. Really, what's wrong with that? I think this is just an opportunity, and I really want to thank His Excellency for entrusting me with this opportunity. It would be even, I don't know what people of Mbarara think, but really, if there is someone thinking that he can continue with what I've been fighting for instance, like corruption, then I don't think that is a good idea for him. He should think otherwise, because it will be zero tolerance. You see, we cannot keep looking at the old people who have brought this country from somewhere, crying, grumbling to see that services reach our people, while our people are struggling, suffering in the villages, and people are in offices sharing money. You look at at women fetching water with their heads, instead of using their heads to think money is stranded somewhere. So services are not down, hospitals are not, they are messed up intentionally. To me, I think really I think this is an opportunity.
Behind for the people you have been moving with, who still carry the other version of
it. Like who?
I know you had a group of youth you were moving around with.
Yes. Basically, you are talking of opposition.
Yeah.
Yes. I think I want to advise them that first of all, they should do, if whatever they are calling struggle is for the national good. If there is an opportunity to make sure at least you fix one problem, you get an opportunity of fixing one of the problems you've been fighting for, please grab it. Whatever else you are waiting for will get you on the way. What is very important is this country. Yes, it is our country. If you can help one person, even in this COVID, if you can get one family and help it, you've done more than good.
Is there any moment you regret in life from this time you are coming
from? Of course I regret being part of some of the opposition people whose agenda is, you see, we have to be frank, most of the people, their agendas are personal. Some people have grievances on their hearts with their bosses, maybe frustration, because at a certain point he has been told, no, you can now stay beside us, let someone else fix this. But they don't really feel the pain which people are feeling down. So if someone says, yeah, you see, we are going to do this, we are going to do this, people think you are really fighting for them. While in actual sense, it is you and your family. It's very unfortunate and quite absurd. But they, what do people in opposition promise? What do they have? They promise change, that when change comes, services are going to be better, corruption will be put to an end. Who has delivered? Who of them has even bothered to deliver that? So I'm saying they have not delivered, and I don't really think they can even deliver. But with me, there is now an opportunity. Yes, there is an opportunity to fix something. Please, Ugandans should allow me take this opportunity. If I can fix one or two issues, I'll be very grateful. Very much, first from the appointing authority who has entrusted me, and to the people that I'm going to serve, Ugandans. Because my deeds now, they are the ones to judge me. This is an opportunity. And you see, people take, if I've been really appointed, what makes me think that someone else can't do what I'm doing? So you come today, someone else will come tomorrow. This is a Uganda of all of us. Yes. If an appointing authority think you can do something, you are given that opportunity. What is important is to use it very well, so that really I don't disappoint a person who appointed me and the people I'm going to serve. Because I might end up being a problem myself. Instead of the appointing authority says, please go there and help me fix something. Instead of fixing, I become a problem myself. That is very unfortunate. I think we have an opportunity to be gauged, so that the society can also know that we really had a cause. Yes, a genuine cause. Yes.
I was just forgetting it. After the news of your appointment, there has been a talk that maybe this appointment is coming as a result of your former boss, Amama Mbabazi,
yes,
whom in the past we have also seen him mending relationship with President Museveni.
Yes.
Could this be one of the agreements? So your appointment, can we say it has been brokered through him?
Through him? That is totally negative. It has absolutely nothing. And I don't think he can actually negotiate something on my behalf. I don't think so. Whatever he may negotiate, may it be his. To me, I think because, first of all, I've ever got an opportunity to share with His Excellency. Because as an old man, he has always had interest to know what is actually a problem. Because he asked me, why this frustration? Why do you look frustrated? I explained to him genuinely. I told him, His Excellency, I'm really not happy with some things which I see here and there in our societies. And he explained to me, he said, really we should be genuine when we are blaming our leaders on that. Because they pick leaders from our societies. He said, these are your brothers, we cannot call Chinese to come and do everything here where we have our children here. So when they pick someone from down and they appoint him with some authority to make sure that he can serve his fellow Ugandans, and then he become a problem, he frustrates them. Of course, we have always been taking all the blame to His Excellency. But he said, please, if you can even tell me one thing, which you said that directly, you are part of the frustration. I could not even find anything. So by that time, I think I became convinced. And I went back, of course I went back. For me, I've been in Mbarara doing my businesses, doing farming, since businesses are not been working in Kampala. I had nothing much to do in Kampala. It is from there that I've seen this, and I really think this is a great opportunity and honor. I want to use this opportunity to thank His Excellency already Museveni for entrusting me with this, and I really promise that I will not disappoint him. I will not disappoint him and Ugandans at large.
I was just forget. People say the role of RDC or RCC,
yes,
it is a mere job of just eating government money. Are you,
yes,
going to eat or you are going to serve?
Yeah. First of all, to my knowledge, because I've been at that office already, actually it is the news that I've run of it when it is late. It has been there for some time, like a month or something. To my knowledge, I don't really think there is money. Which money are they talking about? Because he does not handle, he has no budget for anything. It is just supervisory roles that are there. Implementation, supervisory, to make sure that there is efficiency, to make sure that... So there is nothing, the salary is very, very, very minimal, but once you have a passion, really to serve this country, that's why for me I'm grateful. I'm saying I will help, by the work that I will be doing, at least I will help someone in the society, yes.